Hello friends, good morning. So today's class आज के लिए हम जो पढ़ाने जाएंगे that is actually आपने देखे हैं welcome to Mission Gate 2021. It's a crash course where we are going to deal with we will take you to that particular part where briefly you will get the essence of Gate 2021. So I have already started the environmental engineering course. And I have told you that what is the weightage of this particular subject in your GATE exam. And we have already discussed about the first chapter, that is population forecasting and water demand. That and after the discussion of that population forecasting and water demand, we have solved the questions also. Today, aaj hum log kya karne jayenge? Aaj hum log second chapter jo hai, briefly we will discuss that. Source and conveyance of water, and then we will go for the most important chapter of the domestic water supply segment, that is nothing but the quality of water. Okay, now before going to the details of the subject, आपको एक बार just reminder दे रहा हूँ कि भैया अगर आपके पास अभी तक भी Unacademy learning app नहीं है, go to your Play Store for in your Android device or iPhone device, whatever it's there. And install Unacademy learning app, and there you can click the GATE and EAC, because you are going for the GATE and EAC. You can tell your other fellow mates for other courses also, and then you can join the Unacademy Plus. During taking the subscription, please don't forget to apply my code, that is SEN10. That is my code. This code can be applied. This code will be applied during can be applied during your subscription process. Now, a very good news for the those students who are actually evolved for that is for the aspirants for GATE 2022. आप लोगों के लिए बहुत अच्छा न्यूज है कि भैया सिविल बैच जो है बैच एक चालू हो रहा है 28 दिसंबर 28 दिसंबर सुबह 11:15 से. टॉप एजुकेटर्स विल बी देयर एंड इन इंग्लिश एंड हिंदी बोथ द लैंग्वेज द बैच इज देयर. वेल एंड व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू इफ यू आर जॉइनिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर बैच सब्सक्रिप्शन में, वंस अगेन मैं आपको याद दिलाना चाहता हूँ कि भैया कोड जो है वो SEN10 अप्लाई ना करना भूले. You are going to get a good amount of discounts in the course fee itself. Now we are going for the chapter 2, source and conveyance of water. Source and conveyance of water, where we will see that in the first chapter what we have discussed. Pehla chapter mein hum log kya dekhe hain? Pehla chapter mein hum log ye dekh chuke hain ki What will be the total amount of water required? कितना पानी आपको सप्लाई करना है, कैसे देखे हैं डिफरेंट टाइप्स का डिमांड देख चुके हैं, और उसके साथ साथ हम लोग पॉपुलेशन फोरकास्टिंग क्या होते हैं, कैसे आज 2020 में खड़ा होकर हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू डिटेल द पॉपुलेशन वैल्यू आफ्टर 2 decades, 3 decades, 1 decade. सो दोज थिंग्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन. We have seen that what will be the different types of water demand and what will be the population forecasting process. पॉपुलेशन फोरकास्टिंग प्रोसेस क्या होते हैं दैट वी हैव सीन. नाउ आफ्टर एस्टिमेटिंग कितना डिमांड है, कितना अमाउंट ऑफ पानी सप्लाई करना है, ये सारी चीज एस्टिमेट करने का बाद आपका काम क्या होगा, आपका काम होगा कि कौन सा सोर्स से आप पानी को चुनोगे. क्योंकि अगर आपको दिन में 1000 ml का पानी सप्लाई करना है, तब कोई एक छोटा मोटा तालाब तो आप नहीं चुनने वाले हो. Understood. So eventually, when you are talking about the source and conveyance of water, it is related to how much water you need to supply for the domestic water supply engineering process. Because your source and conveyance will be done on the basis of how much water you need to supply for that process. Generally, two type of sources are there. One is surface sources. Surface source का मतलब क्या है? जमीन के ऊपरी भाग में जो पानी आपको मिल रहा है. Ponds, lake, streams and rivers or reservoirs. Subsurface source मतलब क्या है? जमीन के अंदर. That can be springs, infiltration works, wells, etc. Now here we are going to see certain amount of. This is a chapter which is more over related to hydrological process. we are going to discuss this chapter just for the basic information provided. Now the thing is, what are the subsurface source? Springs, infiltration works, wells. Spring, what is spring? It is the natural outcropping of groundwater. Natural outcropping of groundwater. When the groundwater is coming to the surface, naturally, it is called as spring. Two things is very important. Quality is very good, undoubtedly, but the quantity will be lesser. Quality of this water is very, very good, but the quantity will be lesser. Infiltration works will be of two types. Infiltration galleries, infiltration well. To collect the infiltrated water at the bank or bed of a river. Infiltration works are being used to collect the infiltrated water at the bank or bed of the river. Infiltration works are being used. Infiltration works do tarike ke hote hain, infiltration gallery, infiltration well. What is infiltration gallery? It is the tunnel dug at shallow depth at the bed or bank of river. And what is infiltration well? It is the hole made in the water bearing stream at the river bed or river bank. So infiltration gallery or well mein farak kya hai? Ki gallery mein kya ho raha hai ki tunnel taiyar kiya jata hai aur shallow depth matlab depth bahut zyada nahi hote hain. Infiltration well mein the tunnel is made at the water bearing stratum. मतलब जिस लेवल पे पानी बह रहा है उस लेवल पे वाटर बियरिंग होल हो सकता है क्योंकि डजंट मैटर व्हाट एवर विल बी द डेप्थ. डेप्थ यहाँ पे ज्यादा कम दोनों ही हो सकता है. वेल्स. व्हाट इज वेल्स? इज अ वर्टिकल होल मेड इन ग्राउंड टू टैप द ग्राउंड वाटर. इट इज द वर्टिकल होल मेड इन ग्राउंड टू टैप द ग्राउंड वाटर. यू मे हैव सीन wells in your village homes. Wells will be of two type, open wells or dug wells. Open wells or dug wells diameter generally vary in between 2 to 9 meter and depth will not be more than 17 meter. Where water yield matlab kitna pani de raha hai will be Q will vary in between 2 to 6 liter per second. Q will vary in between 2 to 6 liter per second. Now there will be tube well or bore wells. Tube wells or bore wells will be dia will be 15 to 30 centimeter and depth will be 20 to 70 meter. Where water yield will be 15 to 45 liter per second. Water yield will be 15 to 45 liter per second. So ओपन वेल और डग वेल और ट्यूब वेल और बोर वेल्स का जो अंतर है जो फर्क है वहां पे लिखा हुआ है. सो डायमीटर फॉर ट्यूब वेल और बोर वेल्स इट विल बी डायमीटर 15 टू 30 सेंटीमीटर. नाउ व्हाट इज बोर वेल्स आर मोस्टली यूज्ड. डेप्थ विल बी 20 टू 70 मीटर एंड वाटर यील्ड विल वेरी इन बिटवीन 15 टू 45 लीटर पर सेकेंड. फॉर ओपन वेल्स डायमीटर विल बी इन बिटवीन 2 टू 9 मीटर बट डेप्थ विल नॉट बी मोर देन 17 मीटर. The water yield will be 2 to 6 liter per second. Now, what is intake? It is a structure constructed at surface water bodies for the safe withdrawal of water over a predetermined period. It is a structure constructed at surface water bodies. For safe withdrawal of water over a predetermined period. Now, the collection, storage and deliver, if all those things are done, it will be called as wet intake, as example, river intake. So once again, I am repeating, it is a structure constructed at the surface water bodies for safe withdrawal of water over a predetermined period. एक पर्टिकुलर पीरियड में आप जितना पानी लेने के लिए एक स्ट्रक्चर दिया जाता है. इट विल बी ऑफ थ्री टाइप, वेट इनटेक, ड्राई इनटेक एंड सबमर्ज इनटेक. व्हाट इज वेट इनटेक? एग्जांपल ऑफ वेट इनटेक इज रिवर इनटेक व्हिच विल डू थ्री जॉब, कलेक्शन, storage and deliver. Dry intake is reservoir intake, which will collect the water and deliver the water. No storage will be there. Submerged intake is the intake submerged in water, which is actually the lake intake. Okay. Now, conveyance. Conveyance means matlab kya hai? Conveyance ka matlab hota hai transportation. The conveyance of water. The conveyance of water is actually done by two methods. One is gravity conveyance and another one is pressure conveyance. Gravity conveyance is done by open channel flow. Any kind of channel, any kind of the irrigation water, surface irrigation water supply is done by open channel flow. You may have seen many open channel flow. And pressure conveyance method will be done by pipe flow. That means pressure conveyance means where pipes, pumps are required. This pressure conveyance is preferred to gravity conveyance. And to design the pressure conveyance, we need to go that the size of the pipe will be fixed and the capacity of the pump has to be fixed. Pressure conveyance is preferred over gravity conveyance because the losses will be lesser in case of pressure conveyance. Okay. Now, briefly, I told you that briefly we are going to discuss this segment. Two equations are point of concern. One is Darcy-Weisbach equation, which is HL is equals to where head loss is measured, FL V square by 2GD, or it can be expressed as FL Q square by 12.1 D to the power 5. Okay, where F is the friction factor, L is the length of pipe, V is the velocity of flow, Q is the discharge, G is the acceleration due to gravity, and d is the pipe diameter. Another equation is there, which will be used to find out the velocity of flow, that is called as Hazen-Wilhelm equation, where Hazen-Wilhelm equation is equals to V is equals to 0.85 CH R to the power, capital R to the power 0.63. S to the power 0.54. Here, CH is Hazen's constant and capital R, don't forget, that this capital R is nothing but the hydraulic radius. Don't get confused the R with others. It is nothing but hydraulic radius. It is not the normal radius, okay? It's hydraulic radius, which is equals to area by weighted perimeter. Now, what is weighted? The difference between weighted perimeter and normal perimeter? Suppose this is a rectangular section. This is A, this is B, this is A, this much of water is there. So if your normal perimeter P will be 2 into A plus B, that you know from the childhood days. But weighted perimeter will be the section, the periphery, which is actually submerged or mixed, attached with water. That is A plus B plus A, or it will be 2A plus B. Hope you understand that. It is 2A plus B. And S is actually the slope, which is H by L, and Q is equals to AV by continuity equation that will be used in lot many cases. Okay. So, in brief, what we have done in this chapter, that is actually the chapter. So, source of water, so how we are going to choose a source? By estimating how much water we need to supply. The source will be of two types, surface water source and subsurface water source. Surface water sources are ponds, lakes, stream or rivers, and reservoir. Subsurface water source will be springs, infiltration works, wells, etc. What is spring? Is a natural outcropping of groundwater where the quality of water will be very good, but the quantity will be much, much lesser. So, infiltration work. What is infiltration work? It is to collect the infiltrated water at the bank or bed of river. Now, it will be of two types, infiltration galleries and infiltration wells. What is infiltration gallery? It is a tunnel dug at shallow depth at the bed or bank of river. What is infiltration wells? It is a hole made in the water bearing stratum at the river bed or river bank. Now, what is wells? Will be the vertical hole made in ground to tap the groundwater. Wells will be of two types, open wells or dug wells, and tube well or bore wells. Open wells will having the diameter 2 to 9 meter, where depth will be more than will not be more than 17 meter. Where water will vary between 2 to 6 liter per second. In case of tube well or bore wells, diameter will be in between 15 to 30 centimeter and depth will be 20 to 70 meter. And the water yield Q will vary in between 15 to 45 liter per second. Now coming to the thing, index. It is a structure constructed at surface water bodies for safe withdrawal of water over a predetermined period. Where collection, storage and delivery will be done by wet intake, as example, river intake. Where only collection and delivery will be done in case of dry intake, as example, reservoir intake. Another intake type of intake is there, submerged intake, which where intake submerged in water, as example, lake intake. Now we are going for the conveyance of water. The conveyance of water will be of two types. Water will get conveyed from one place to another. One is gravity conveyance method. Another one is pressure conveyance method. In gravity conveyance method, which will be done by open channel flow, and the pressure conveyance method will be done by pipe flow. And generally, in the pressure conveyance method, pipes, pumps are required. It is preferred to gravity conveyance. And to design the pressure conveyance, first we need to fix the size of the pipe and then fix the capacity of the pump. Two equations are there which will be actually defining the thing. One is Darcy-Weisbach equation. Which is HL is equals to FLV square by 2GD. Or FLQ square by 12.1 into D to the power 5. And another one is Hazel-Williams equation, where V will be 0.85 CH, capital R to the power 0.63, S to the power 0.54. F will be friction factor, L will be length of pipe, Q is the discharge, V is the velocity, G is acceleration due to gravity, small d is the diameter of pipe. Here CH is Hazel's constant, R is the hydraulic radius, which is not the actual radius. R is equals to A by PW, area by wetted perimeter. And S, slope, is H by L. And Q equals to AV is the continuity equation. Well, now one question I have listed here. First, concentrate on the question. A town with population 50,000 supplied water at a rate of 200 LPCD. Draw water from a source which is 10 km away from it. Elevation difference between source and supply is 8 meters. Find the dia of conveying pipe if the friction factor is 0.01. Once again, a town with population 50,000 supplied water at a rate of 200 LPCD draw water from a source which is 10 km away from it. Elevation difference between source and supply is 8 meter and dia of conveying pipe is friction factor if F is 0.01. So head loss they're asking, so HL will be equals to, you can follow the solution. HL is equals to FLV square by 2GD or else it is FLQ square by 12.1 into D to the power 5. Now, Q value is not given. Its Q average is what? Population into per capita water demand. Eventually, it is getting as 10 into 10 to the power 6 liter per day, that is 10 MLD, and is converted into meter cube per second, it will be 0.1157 meter cube per second. Directly, if you put friction factor value 0.01 provided into 10 into 1000, that is L. L is given as 10 kilometers, so it's converting into meter, and 0.1157 whole square. That is the Q. Final by 12.1 into D to the power 5, and head loss is provided as 8. It is told. See. So here, unknown is diameter of the pipe, which will be, if you calculate it, it will be 0.42 meter. It will be 0.42 meter. Let's go for the second question. The 10 MLD of water is supplied to a town from source which is 8 km away from supply. Elevation difference is 100 meter. Find the dia of conveying pipe if CH is equals to 100. So once again, it is provided Q equals to 10 MLD converting into meter cube per second. It's 11.1157 meter cube per second. Where V will be equals to here, CH is given, means we need to apply this Hazen-Williams equation, where V is equals to 0.85 CH R to the power 0.63 into S to the power 0.54. For a circular pipeline, R is equals to A by PW, right? So what is area? Area is pi by 4 D square. Perimeter will be pi D, weighted perimeter. It will be eventually D by 4. So V is equals to 0.85, CH value 100 is provided to you, into D by 4. See, D by 4, R is D by 4, into H by L to the power 0.54. S is taken as H by L to the power 0.54. Or Q equals to AV, that is equals to 1157, that is equals to pi by 4 D square area. And V is there, 0.85 into 100 by D by 4, 0.60, 10 by 8000 to the power 0.54. So from here, if you calculate D, will be 0.49 meter. If you calculate D, that will be 0.49 meter. Okay. Quickly have a look on this problem. Well, now solve this question. What is the strainer length required for a deep tube well? Giving a discharge of 8 liter per second. Assume permissible entrance velocity of 2 cm per second. It is desired to have the strainer of slot size 20 mm cross 0.2 mm with number of slots per centimeter length of strainer as 100. I'm giving you certain amount of time. So let's solve the question. Total area of slots required is equals to Q by V as per the continuity equation, that is equals to 8 into n to the power minus 3 by 2 into 10 to the power minus 2, that is equals to 0.4 meters square. Now, area of each slot will be equal to 20 into 0.2 mm square, that is equals to 4 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square. So number of slots required is equals to total area of slots by area of each slot or one slot. Area of one slot. So that is equals to 0.4 by 4 into 10 to the power minus 6. That is equals to 1 lakh. So length of pipe required is equals to total number of slots by slots per centimeter per length. Is equals to 1 lakh by 100 centimeter, that is 1000 centimeter, that is equals to 10 meter. That is equals to 10 meter. Is that clear? Just have a look to the solution. Well, so that is the end of the second chapter. Now we are entering to the third chapter, that is quality of water. So abhi tak hum log kya kar chuke hain? Abhi tak hum log dekh chuke hain ki what will be the amount of water you need to supply or you need to take and what will be the source. Ab kya karna hai? Usko treat karna hai, then you need to supply. Okay. Now, before the treating of water, we need to go for quality of water. What is quality of water? Why it is required? Actually, jab aap kabhi soch lijiye ki our treatment, you need to treat the water. Why? Because you need to make the natural water into purified water. Aapko purified water mein convert karna hai. To treat karna matlab aapko pani ke liye kuch dawai dena hai. Aap abhi pani ke liye doctor ho. जब आपका कोई बीमारी होता है, when you are ill, when you go to a doctor and after looking under some symptoms, what they will prescribe? They'll prescribe some pathological test कि आप USG कर लीजिए, आप अल्ट्रासाउंड मतलब कुछ ECG कर लीजिए, कोई ब्लड टेस्ट होता है, TCDC, लीवर फंक्शन टेस्ट होता है, वो सब कर लीजिए. Why they are doing this? Why they are prescribing this? Because they want to know what is the exact problem is happening inside your body. Because if you are having a problem in your liver and they will give you a medicine of kidney, it will not work. आपके अंदर क्या दिक्कतें हैं? वो दिक्कतें को देखने के लिए doctor does this pathological test. और pathological test का report जब आता है, तब क्या होता है कि जो जिसका जो है पैरामीटर्स के साथ साथ दो और भी कॉलम रहते हैं. एक कॉलम में कितना क्या वैल्यू है और एक कॉलम में आता है कि कौन कौन स्टैंडर्ड वैल्यू है. वैसे ही क्वालिटी असेसमेंट इज एक्चुअली द पैथोलॉजिकल टेस्ट ऑफ वाटर वेयर यू आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट दैट व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स एसोसिएटेड विद द वाटर एंड बिकॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट प्रॉब्लम यू आर गोइंग टू इम्पोज द ट्रीटमेंट स्कीम. बिकॉज इफ द वाटर इज हैविंग अ प्रॉब्लम इन टर्म्स ऑफ आयरन कंटेंट, you can't treat the water by removing the arsenic. समझ में आया कि नहीं? तो ये क्वालिटी का काम है टू फाइंड आउट दैट व्हाट आर द ट्रीटमेंट स्कीम विल बी देयर. अब ये जो क्वालिटी चेकिंग है, ये क्वालिटी चेकिंग सिस्टम में दो बार होते हैं, एक बार ट्रीटमेंट से पहले, एक बार ट्रीटमेंट के बाद डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन से पहले. सो क्वालिटी चेकिंग इन दिस स्लाइड यू मे हैव सीन दैट क्वालिटी इज एक्चुअली डन ट्वाइस इन दिस सिस्टम. वन इज बिफोर द ट्रीटमेंट, अनदर वन इज आफ्टर द ट्रीटमेंट. सो बिफोर द ट्रीटमेंट दिस क्वालिटी चेकिंग इज डन. This quality checking is done to find out that what are the different types of treatment unit or treatment scheme you are going to impose. But what is the use of this quality checking? This quality checking is used to check whether your treatment unit is discharging desired quality water or not, whether that treated water is really treated or not, whether that treated water is suitable for distribution or not. मतलब आप एक बार दवाई देने से पहले pathological test कर रहे हो कि भैया देख लेते हैं कि पानी में problem क्या क्या है, उसके बाद दवाई देने के बाद एक बार pathological test कर रहे हो कि भैया देख लेते हैं कि ये सारे दवाई जो मैं दिया हूं वो दवाई काम कर रहा है कि नहीं. Now classification of impurities. Clear? Impurities generally classified into different segments, and they are classified first of all the based on the size of the impurity. First of all, based on the size of the impurity. Based on the size of the impurity, impurities are classified into three types. One is suspended solid, another one is colloidal particle, and next one is dissolved solids. Suspended solid, colloidal particle, and dissolved solids. Suspended solids with size ranges in between 10 to the power minus 1 to minus 3 millimeter in diameter. Suspended solid is size ranges in between 10 to the power minus 1 to minus 3 millimeter in diameter. And this particular solid is visible to human eye. This particular solid is visible to human eye. And these particular impurities or solids are called as macro impurity. These particular impurity or solids are called as macro impurity. Colloidal particle size ranges in between 10 to the power minus 3 to minus 5 mm in dia. Colloidal particle size ranges in between 10 to the power minus 3 to 10 to the power minus 5 mm in dia. And the dissolved impurity, the size ranges in between 10 to the power minus 5 to 10 to the power minus 8 mm in dia. When you are talking about the colloidal impurity and dissolved impurity, both combinedly, they are not visible to human eye and they are combinedly called as micro impurity. Remember, in the chemical analysis, we will see that the colloidal particle and dissolved solids combinedly called as total dissolved solids. We will discuss this later on. So, the size of the particle, you need to remember it very generously. Suspended solid, colloidal impurity, and dissolved solid. Suspended solid size ranges in between 10 to the power minus 1 to minus 3 mm in diameter. Colloidal impurity with size ranges in between 10 to the power minus 3 to minus 5 mm in diameter. And the dissolved solid size ranges in between 10 to the power minus 5 to minus 8 mm in diameter. So these are the classification based on the size of the impurity. Now, based on the nature of the impurity, it will be of two type, inorganic and organic impurity. Based on the nature of the impurity, it will be of two type, inorganic and organic impurity. And based on state, it will be of three type, physical impurity, chemical impurity, and biological impurity. Based on nature, it will be of two type, inorganic impurity and organic impurity. Based on state, it will be of three types, physical impurity, chemical impurity, and biological impurity. Now, we need to discuss about different physical impurity parameters, chemical impurity parameters, and biological impurity parameters. Just have a look. Now, we are going for the physical water quality parameters. Physical water quality parameters. Now, before starting the different physical water quality parameters, आपको ये गौर तरीके से समझिए. What is physical water quality parameters? Physical water quality parameters are those characteristics of water which will be respond to human senses like sight, touch, feel, taste and smell. मतलब एक पानी को देखते हुए, उसको छूते हुए, उसको स्मेल करते हुए या तो उसका टेस्ट लेते हुए आप बता रहे हो कि भैया ये पानी साफ है कि नहीं, भैया ये पानी पीने लायक है कि नहीं. These are the parameters which can be respond to human senses. Like this is the water is there. So lot many things is there in my mind by observing. Okay. This is okay to drink. Like this, it's going to happen. None of the physical water quality parameters causes detrimental health effects. कोई भी physical water quality parameter ऐसा नहीं है जो इंसान का मौत का reason हो सके. लेकिन we will try to remove these properties for the mindset of the users, for the satisfaction of the users, for the aesthetic view of the users. Physical water quality parameter क्या हो सकता है? जैसे temperature. Temperature मतलब पानी गर्म है कि नहीं, वो आप छू के बता सकते हो. Color. पानी में पानी का color है कि colored water है कि नहीं, पानी साफ सुथरा है कि नहीं, वो आप देख के बता सकते हो. ऐसे बोतल का ढक्कन खुले और ऐसे स्मेल किए और अगर गंदा स्मेल आ रहा है तो देख के समझ में आता है कि पानी साफ नहीं है, पानी गंदा है. The point is, what is the satisfaction of users? Actually, ये पूरा दिमाग का खेल है. मैं अभी अगर एक रेड कलर का पानी मैं आपको देता हूं तो आप पहले ही पूछोगे क्या मिलावट है. क्यों? क्योंकि हम जानते हैं कि ये जो पानी है, नॉर्मली जनरल ड्रिंकिंग वाटर शुड बी कलरलेस. तो जैसे ही रेड कलर है मतलब कुछ ना कुछ मिलावट है. अच्छा बुरा छोड़ दीजिए, कुछ ना कुछ मिलावट है. मैं तो आपको बोला कि रुआब्जा है, रोज वाटर मिला हुआ है. तो आपको क्या लग रहा है कि अच्छा रोज वाटर मिला हुआ है मतलब टेस्ट अच्छा होने वाला है, चलो पीते हैं. लेकिन पहले आप पूछ रहे हैं, पहले आपका माइंड को क्वेश्चन कर रहे हैं, माइंड से आपका क्वेश्चन आ रहा है कि समथिंग इज देयर. बीइंग अ इंजीनियर यू मे हैव आस्क्ड कि भाई कौन सा ब्रांड मिला हुआ है, दैट्स डिफरेंट इशू. लेकिन वंस अगेन यू विल आस्क समथिंग एंड डिफरेंट फिजिकल वाटर क्वालिटी पैरामीटर्स आर टेम्परेचर, कलर, टेस्ट एंड ऑर्डर एंड टर्बिडिटी. टेम्परेचर, कलर, टेस्ट एंड ऑर्डर एंड turbidity. Now we will briefly discuss the different physical water quality parameters. The first one is temperature. Actually, microorganism growth generally enhanced in the temperature range 25 to 40 degrees centigrade. Us temperature range mein microorganism growth ग्रोथ अच्छा होते हैं. अगर उस आप पानी का टेम्परेचर को 65 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड तक लेके जाते हो तो मोस्ट ऑफ द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, यहाँ पे देखिए आप लिखा हुआ है एम म्यू ओ, इट्स एक्चुअली ब्रीफ ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. आप इसको फॉलो मत कीजिए, आई एम फॉलोइंग इट बिकॉज ऑफ द कन्वीनियंस, जस्ट नॉट मीन्स वेरी लेजी पर्सन आई एम, सो आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू राइट दैट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म बिग वर्ड. जनरली 65 के आसपास अगर टेम्परेचर होता है तो माइक्रोऑर्गेनिज्म ऑलमोस्ट डाई होते हैं, मतलब मोस्ट ऑफ द माइक्रोऑर्गेनिज्म विल डाई. अगर 95 तक लेके जाते हैं तो नॉर्मली माइक्रोऑर्गेनिज्म विल, ऑल द माइक्रोऑर्गेनिज्म विल डाई. इसीलिए आप लोग बचपन में देखे होंगे कि आपके मम्मी पापा जी क्या कर रहे हैं, वो लोग पानी को उबाल के उसको ठंडा करके फिर पिला रहे हैं. क्यों? क्योंकि एट द हायर टेम्परेचर माइक्रोऑर्गेनिज्म डिस्ट्रॉयड. लेकिन अगर मैं आपको बहुत ज्यादा गर्म पानी, आप कोरोना सिचुएशन का छोड़ दीजिए, कोरोना सिचुएशन में लोगों ने जितना गर्म पानी पिया है जिंदगी भर उतना कभी नहीं पिया है. आप कोरोना सिचुएशन छोड़ दीजिए, लेकिन नॉर्मली अगर आपको गर्म पानी दिया जाए पीने के टाइम पे, आप बोल रहे कि बहुत प्यास लगा है, आप उस पानी को पियेंगे? आंसर इज नो. Why? Though it is a good quality water, but you will not drink it because that is in your mindset कि पानी का टेम्परेचर एक नॉर्मल रूम टेम्परेचर वाला या उससे थोड़ा कम होना चाहिए. ओके, नाउ टेम्परेचर लेस देन 10 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड विल ऑल्सो कॉज थ्रोट इन्फेक्शन एंड ऑल्सो इंक्रीज द विस्कोसिटी ऑफ वाटर. विस्कोसिटी का मतलब क्या है? अगर पानी इस डायरेक्शन में फ्लो करने का कोशिश कर रहा है या तो फ्लूइड, देन विस्कोसिटी विल हैपन, विस्कोसिटी विल एक्ट ऑपोजिट टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन. विस्कोसिटी विल एक्ट ऑपोजिट टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन. सो अगर पानी का विस्कोसिटी बढ़ जाता है, देन यू नीड टू गिव मोर पावर, यू नीड टू गिव मोर पावर टू कैरी और टू कन्वे द वाटर. मतलब कॉस्ट ऑफ द कन्वीयंस विल गेट इंक्रीज्ड. Now, if the temperature is more than 20 degree centigrade, some chemical reaction and solubility of some gases like oxygen will get influenced. Kaisa influence hota hai? Ki solubility is inversely proportional to temperature. Matlab, solubility badhne se, uska milawat hone ka jo ratio hai, jo rate hai, wo ghat jayega. Now, supply of water for drinking water purpose should be in the range of in between 15 to 20 degree centigrade. Supply of water for drinking water purpose should be in the range of 15 to 20 degree centigrade. That you need to remember. Now, in brief, what are the temperature? So, temperature is that microorganism growth generally enhanced in the temperature range. If temperature is more than 65, most of the microorganism will die, and beyond 95 degree centigrade, all the microorganism will die. Less than 10 degree centigrade will cause throat infection and also increase the viscosity of water, which will lead to more power required to convey the water. That's clear. And also solubility of some gases like oxygen, temperature will influence the solubility, where it is inversely proportional. Now coming to the color. Who is creating color to water? Agar aap is pani mein thoda sa copper sulfate mila denge, to is pani ka color ho jayega blue. Iron salt mila denge, to pani ka color ho jayega reddish. Or sometimes, if you mix some सॉइल पार्टिकल, अगर कुछ मिट्टी मिला देंगे तो इस पानी का कलर हो जाएगा ब्राउन. और अगर बहुत दिनों तक अगर पानी इस बोतल के अंदर रहेगा तो उसके बाद आप देखेंगे ग्रीनिश कलर, दैट इज द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म ग्रोथ. सो लॉट मेनी थिंग्स इज गिविंग कलर टू वाटर. डिजॉल्व ऑर्गेनिक मैटर और इनऑर्गेनिक सॉल्ट विल इम्पार्ट कलर टू वाटर. समटाइम्स हेवी ग्रोथ ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म विल ऑल्सो गिव अ ग्रीनिश कलर टू वाटर. In certain cases, suspended solid will also give color to water. The color of water is measured in Burger scale. And Nessler tube and tintometer are the two instruments to measure color in water. Nessler tube and tintometer are the two instruments which measure color in water in Burger scale. And when they're measuring the color in water, the value will be expressed in TCU, true color unit, where one standard color is defined as when 1 milligram of platinum cobalt salt or 1 milligram of platinum in the form of chloroplatinate ion dissolved in 1 liter of distilled water, then the color produced is called as 1 TCU. Once again, I'm repeating the definition. When 1 milligram of platinum cobalt salt or 1 milligram of platinum in the form of chloroplatinate ion dissolved in 1 liter of distilled water, then the color produced is called as 1 TCU or drinking, okay, or true color unit. Color is generally of two type. Agar color सस्पेंडेड पार्टिकल के वजह से तैयार हो रहा है, पानी में आ रहा है, देन इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज एपरेंट कलर. एंड इफ द कलर is caused by dissolved solid, then it will be called as true color. So just look at the color part. That drinking water standard for color is 5 to 20 TCU. Drinking water standard for color is 5 to 20 TCU. Now we are going for the next parameter, that is turbidity. Turbidity क्या है? देखिए, अगर इस ये bottle plain bottle होता, तो light can pass through water directly in a straight line. Light ray can pass in a straight line through pure water. Now, due to the presence in suspended and colloidal particle, अगर इस पानी में मिट्टी का मिलावट हो गया, तो इस पानी का उस पार्ट से इस पार्ट से उस पार्ट को नहीं दिखा जाएगा. We will not able to see the opposite side of the water from this side. Why? Because opaqueness is created. Why? Because light is not getting that path to penetrate the water through straight line. Actually, light is getting certain resistance to penetrate. And this is due to the presence of suspended and colloidal particle in water. This is due to the presence of suspended and colloidal particle in water. So turbidity is actually the measurement of light property. It is actually measuring what? It is actually measuring that what is happening with the light. What is happening means what is happening with the light by the particle. How much light is getting absorbed? How much light is getting scattered? How much light is getting reflected? How much light is getting refracted? Turbidity is measuring that. But it is directly measuring the light property, but it is actually indirectly measuring the concentration of suspended and colloidal particle. क्यों? क्योंकि जितना ज्यादा सस्पेंडेड एंड कोलाइडल पार्टिकल का प्रेजेंस होगा उतना ही ज्यादा टर्बिडिटी होगा. डायरेक्टली इट इज मेजरिंग द लाइट प्रॉपर्टी, बट इनडायरेक्टली इट इज मेजरिंग द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ सस्पेंडेड एंड कोलाइडल पार्टिकल. इज द डिस्क्रिप्शन गिवन द टर्बिडिटी इज अ सरफेस फेनोमेना नॉट अ मास फेनोमेना. टर्बिडिटी सरफेस एरिया के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है, मास के ऊपर नहीं. ये डिस्क्रिप्शन का मैं समझा रहा हूँ, गौर तरीके से समझिए, देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द डिस्क्रिप्शन. नाउ फॉरगेट द डेरिवेशंस रिटन इन द स्लाइड. सपोज इन द वाटर सपोज दिस इज योर वाटर पॉइंट. There one particular particle is present which is having 1 meter plus 1 meter plus 1 meter dimension. Okay, and suppose 5 light rays are passing through it, and this particular particle is restricting 2 light particles. These particular particles are restricting 2 light particles, light rays, and so eventually the 2 out of 5, this much of degree of turbidity is created. Now this particle is 1 meter cross 1 meter cross 1 meter. So surface area of this particle will be 6 meter square, and volume of this particle is 1 meter cube. Now what we are doing, we are going to break that particular particle. Now we are going to break that particular particle into smaller size particle of 1 mm × 1 mm × 1 mm. We are going to break the smaller size particle of 1 mm × 1 mm × 1 mm. But each and every particle will be volume 1 mm cube and surface area is 6 mm square. So one single particle you are breaking into 1 mm cross 1 mm cross 1 mm. So how many the number of particles? It is 1 meter cube by 1 mm cube. It's 10 to the power 9. So one single particle is creating 6 mm square surface area. So total surface area will be generated will be 6 into 10 to the power 9 mm square, which will be 6000 meter square. Total surface area generated will be 6000 meter square. So previously 6 meter square surface area is getting generated. Now 6000 meter square surface area is getting generated 1000 times more. So same situation, system, lot many particles, 10 to the power 9 number of particles, all the light rays are getting resistance to the flow, 5 out of 5 is the degree of turbidity. More opaqueness is created. Mass fixed है भैया, क्योंकि वही जो particle था उसी को तोड़ के हम 10 to the power 9 number of particles बना रहे हैं, तो कोई अलग से mass नहीं add कर रहे हैं, mass fixed है. What we are doing? We are only creating more number of surfaces, then we are getting more surface area. There is nothing happening with the mass, only more surface area. And here we are concerned about the particle 1 mm cross 1 mm and cross 1 mm. If smaller the size of the particle, more number of particles will be generated. If more number of particles are getting generated, more surface area will be there. What is the size ranges for surface suspended particles? 10 to the power minus 1 to minus 3 mm. Matlab isse bhi chota, matlab aur bhi jyada. और भी ज्यादा पार्टिकल्स तैयार होता, और भी ज्यादा सरफेस एरिया जनरेट होगा. जैसे आप देखोगे कि एक एक बड़ा ईंट का टुकड़ा अगर लेके रखोगे, जितना सरफेस एरिया वो कवर करेगा, उसको अगर डस्ट बना दोगे तो बहुत ज्यादा सरफेस एरिया वो कवर कर पाएगा. जो किचन में काम करता है ना, तो उसका देखोगे कि सब्जी का टुकड़ा को अगर छोटा छोटा, या आलू लिए हैं या भिंडी का सब्जी लिए है, कुछ भी अगर गोभी लिए हैं, उसको छोटा छोटा चार पांच टुकड़ा करोगे तो जितना सरफेस में आप रख पाओगे, अगर उसको बहुत छोटा करते हो तो बहुत ज्यादा सरफेस इट विल बी कवर्ड. ओके, सो टर्बिडिटी इज अ सरफेस फिनोमेना, नॉट अ मास फिनोमेना. नाउ टर्बिडिटी इज एस्टिमेटेड ऑन सिलिका स्केल एंड द वैल्यू इज एक्सप्रेस्ड इन टर्बिडिटी यूनिट्स टीयू, वेयर वन स्टैंडर्ड टर्बिडिटी यूनिट इज व्हेन 1 मिलीग्राम ऑफ When 1 milligram of finely divided silica mixed with 1 liter of distilled water, then the turbidity created is called as 1 TU. This particular definition is proposed by Jackson. Ye Michael wala nahi, ye environmental engineering wala Jackson hai. This particular definition is proposed by Jackson and also called as Jackson turbidity unit or JTU. Also called as Jackson turbidity unit or JTU, and it is measured by following devices. Four devices are there which will measure. Ek hai Jackson turbidity meter, ek hai Bailey's turbidity meter, ek hai Hillier's turbidity meter, and nephelometer. Jackson turbidity meter is good to measure greater than 25 JTU value. Bailey's turbidity measure is good to measure 0 to 2 JTU value. Hillier's turbidity meter is good to measure 0 to 50 JTU value. Nephelometer is good to measure for any range. Whereas, the first three, Jackson turbidity meter, Bailey's turbidity meter, and Hillier's turbidity meter, they are based on the principle of light absorption. Whereas, the nephelometer is based on the principle of light scattering. The value of nephelometer is represented by NTU, and it is nephelometric turbidity unit. Apart from nephelometer, all other three, their value is represented by JTU. JTU. Whereas we need to know the definition for NTU, one standard NTU. When 1 milligram of formazine polymer dissolved in 1 liter of distilled water, then the turbidity produced is called as 1 NTU or 1 standard FT, where NTU is equivalent which for our ease of calculation will be taken as same as FTU, and NTU or FTU is equivalent to JTU or TU. But drinking water standard for turbidity is 5 to 10 TU. तो अभी तक हम लोग क्या क्या देख चुके हैं, टेम्परेचर, कलर एंड टर्बिडिटी. नाउ द लास्ट फिजिकल वाटर क्वालिटी पैरामीटर व्हाट वी आर गोइंग फॉर इज टेस्ट एंड ओडर. तो भैया क्या है टेस्ट एंड ओडर के लिए, सोचिए ये बोतल का पानी आप लिए हैं और इसको ढक्कन खोलने के बाद आपको बदबू आ रहा है. इफ ओडर इज बैड विल यू गोइंग टू ड्रिंक इट, नो. तो टेस्ट इज एज्यूम्ड टू बी बैड. If odor is bad, taste is assumed to be bad, and there is no separate taste for test. There is no separate taste for test. Taste के लिए कोई अलग से कोई taste नहीं होता है. And odor is measured by a device called as osmoscope. Odor is measured by a device called as osmoscope. And the value will be expressed in TON. Threshold odor number, मतलब osmoscope device जो value देगा, सोच लीजिए value दिया 5. अगर कोई आपको पूछा कि odor कितना है, तो आप बोलेंगे 5 TON, threshold odor number. अगर कोई आपको पूछा कि taste क्या है, आप बोलेंगे 5, same value, 5 FTN, flavor threshold number. Whereas TON or FTN is expressed by A plus B by A. TON or FTN is expressed by A plus B by A, where A is the volume of water sample used and B is the volume of distilled water used. Generally A plus B will be 200 because 200 is the device volume. In this case, suppose 25 ml A is there, 175 ml B is used. So TON or FTN value will be 200 by 25 is equals to 8. Clear. So slowly I'm once again moving to the physical water quality parameter. The physical water quality parameters are defined those characteristics of water which will respond to human senses of sight, touch, feel, taste, smell. And none of the physical water quality parameters causes detrimental health effects, yet we try to remove these part properties for the satisfaction of the users or aesthetic view of the users. First one is temperature. It is given all the details. Range is 15 to 20 degrees centigrade. Second one is color. Lot many information is provided. Why color is produced? What is measurement? What are the instruments? What are the type of color? What is standard color? Drinking water standard. Then turbidity. Directly measuring the light property. Indirectly measuring concentration of suspended and colloidal particle. And it is a surface phenomena, not a mass phenomena. Hope you understand that thing. Then turbidity is estimated on silica scale and the value is expressed in turbidity units. Standard turbidity units definition is given, proposed by Jackson. Turbidity devices is Jackson turbidity meter, Bayliss meter, Hillage meter and nephelometer. But the first three, Jackson, Bayliss and Hillage meter, are based on principle of light absorption. And nephelometer is based on the principle of light scattering. Jackson meter will be using for 25 greater than 25 JTU. Bayliss Hillage meter is provided. What is NTU is given. Drinking water standard is also mentioned. Now, going for taste and odor. It is given that odor is bad. Taste is assumed to be bad. There is no separate test for test. Odor is measured by a device called as osmoscope. And the value for odor, it will be expressed in TON. For taste, it will be expressed in FT. A TON or FTN is equals to A plus B by A. Okay. So, dosto, just once again, I am telling you, this is the end of physical water quality parameter 2. This is the end of physical water quality parameter 2. In the next session, we will go for chemical water quality parameter. So just to keep you remembering one thing, that if you are aspiring for GATE 2022, civil batch English plus and Hindi is going to be start 28 December from 11:15 a.m. Good educators are being there, but don't forget to use the my code SEM10 when you are subscribing it. If it is the Unacademy educator app is not there in your mobile, then learning app, you can go for Unacademy learning app in your Play Store, install it, put it for Git and ESE, and go for Unacademy Plus, go for the subscription. Once again, I'm telling you, my code is SEN10ACN10. Don't forget to use that particular code for the process. Thank you for this session. For any kind of questions, put in your description box. I will be there. Thanks a lot. Have a good day.